us commend ourselves and each other in all our life unto Christ our God.
For thou art the King of peace, O Christ our God, and unto thee we ascribe glory together with the Father who is from everlasting, and thy holy and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Yeah.
to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Remembrance are all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious, Mary, Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints. Let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Our good God, in all this way, unto you we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Soldiers who watch like evil cities came like dead men, the likeness of the appearing angel, who were claimed by resurrection to women. Wherefore, thee do we glorify, O ruler of corruption, and to thee we do kneel. O thou who didst rise from the grave, among our God.
Thank you.
upon thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in your remembrance, sorrow, Holy Immaculate, most blessed and glorious, the Indian Temple, and ever-worthy Mary. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other, and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Sealed by the very body, and its breach among the people, proclaiming the truth. have mercy on us and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Yes.
cherubim, and unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages, on ages.
Amen. Christ is
again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. Save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remembrance our all holy Immaculate, whose blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Thou art the King of peace, and the Savior of our souls, O Christ our God. And unto thee do we ascribe glory together with the Father, who is from everlasting and all holy, good and mighty Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
mercy upon us. Keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All enduring reverence are all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious, mighty Theotokos, and ever blessed. All the saints, let us defend ourselves and each other and our whole life.
Son and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Thank you. We shall see light, extend your mercy.
us attend.
Praise to thee, O Lord, with my whole heart.
Wisdom.
Reading is from the first epistle of St. Paul to the Corinthians and Galatians.
Let us attend.
Ye brethren, a little leaven corrupteth the whole lump. Purge out the old leaven, that you may be a new paste, as you are unleavened. For Christ our Pascha is sacrificed. Therefore, let us feast not with the old leaven, nor with the leaven of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. Christ hath redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us, for it is written, Cursed be every one that hangeth on a tree, that the blessing of Abraham might come on the Gentiles through Christ Jesus, that we may receive the promise of the Spirit by faith. He speedeth he that readeth.
Into thy spirit. Wisdom at hand, let us hear the Holy Gospel.
Peace be to all.
Into thy spirit.
The reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
Let us attend.
On the next day, that is the day of preparation, the chief priests and the Pharisees gathered before Pilate and said, Sir, we remember how that impostor said while he was still alive, After 3 days I will rise again. Therefore, order the sepulchre to be made secure until the third day, lest his disciples go and steal him away and tell the people he has risen from the dead. And the last fraud will be worse than the first. Pilate said to them, You have a guard of soldiers. Go make it as secure as you can. So they went and they made the sepulchre secure by sealing the stone and setting a guard.
Say with all our soul and with all our mind, let us say, O Lord, Almighty, the God of our fathers, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy.
Have mercy.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to thy great mercy, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
For all pious and Orthodox Christians, for our Father Metropolitan Joseph, for our priests, hierarchs, monks, deacons, hierarchs, deacons, and monastics, and all our brethren in Christ.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for the blessed and ever memorable founders of this holy church, for all our fathers and brethren, the Orthodox departed this life before us, who here and in all the world lie asleep in the Lord.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again we pray for those who bear food and to do good works in this holy and all venerable church, for those who serve and those who sing, and for all the people here present, who wait thy great and rich mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Thou art a merciful God, who lovest mankind, and unto thee be ascribed, Lord, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to ages of ages.
Complete our morning prayer unto the
Lord.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
That the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord.
Peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
Our remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
All things good and profitable for our souls and peace for the world, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, a Christian end to our life, painless, blameless, peaceful, and a good defense before the fearful judgment seat of Christ, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
Calling to remembrance our all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever-Virgin Mary. Let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Unto the Lord.
Reminded is to show mercy and to save us from our God, and unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Of his own immaculate and all blameless Holy Mother, by the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplication of the honorable glorious prophet, forerunner and Baptist John, and of St. Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and of all the saints, have mercy upon us and save us, for as much as he is good and loveth mankind. The prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Amen. Thank you for coming to this. Hello. Thank you for coming. Having this most beautiful meditations. Service, bittersweet it is. You know, it's difficult for us many times to picture the suffering of Christ. We don't like to think of it, but some moviegoers sometimes thrust it into our face, like Mel Gibson did a few years back, things like that. But you know, this is our Lord. We love our Lord. We don't love him perhaps as much or as deeply or with as pure devotion as we should because we're distracted. And, you know, we have so much in our lives that occupy our attention, so many passions, so many thoughts, sometimes too many sins. But in moments of clarity, lucidity, we realize moments like this, what he did for us. All that he suffered. The Son of God, you know, who is the cosmic glue that literally holds your atoms together. God didn't just make the world and then say, well, good luck. The Holy Spirit still gives life to the world. God still nurtures the world. And the Son of God still upholds everything by his power. If the Son of God had wanted, he could have simply let go.
of his persecutors, and their atoms would have dispersed throughout the galaxy. But in his great humility, he permitted it for a greater good. He didn't try, as we so often do, just to escape the moment, to escape the pain, the suffering. But he endured it all for something much greater. He endured the cross. And tonight we are carrying the funeral bier and noted how the noble Joseph have taken down his body, wrapped it in fine linen and spices, and placed it in a new tomb. But it wasn't to stay there for very long. Only person who really knew this was the Theotokos, the Mother of God. If you were paying attention, you know, in the hymns, she says, quickly awaken my son and come back. You know, she knows what's going to happen. She's the one with the clarity of spirit to know what's going to happen. And we know what's going to happen because it's already happened. But let's try to hang on to that sense of devotion, that sense of love, that sense of gratitude for what our Lord has done for us. And tomorrow we come back to notch up our celebration a bit. And you'll get a mouthful of bay leaves if I'm a good shot. And the bay leaves symbolizing victory in the ancient world used to make, you know, the little wreaths that the athletes would wear on their heads. And so already we're celebrating, even though time in the timeline, Christ is still in the grave, yet we know it's going to rise. And we begin a slight celebration. The church just can't wait. I always compare it to like kids who are trying to sleep on Christmas Eve, but they know there's already presents out there under that tree, you know, and that's kind of how we are. But tonight, we think about what our Lord has done for us. Because, you know, the worst possible response for us would be ingratitude. And that's too easy for us, actually. It's very easy for us to be ingrates, ungrates, ungrates. Anyway, we don't want to do that. You have to work. You have to work to remind yourself, thank God for all that he's done for us. And the way that we thank him is not just with emotions, not just with words, but with faith. When we're struck with trials and struggles and tribulations that we wish we had the power to just make the atoms turn to gas and blow away. Instead, we endure them as being from the hand of God for a greater good. You know, that's something to remember as well. So, glory to God in all things. Let us come forward. I will replace the epitaphium on the bier so we can all venerate. And I'll see y'all in about 11 hours or 12.